LEEA. And I'm here with David Cormack, who is the Managing Director of Delphini. Congratulations, David. You're taking up a new role with LEEA in January as the Vice Chairman. Tell me about that.
Yeah, it's something I'm very proud of. I've been director of LEEA now for about 5 years. I've been a member of the technical committee for a few years longer than that, and very proud to have been voted by my other directors and the members to become vice chairman.
And you'll be working alongside Oliver Austin, who will now replace Kat Moss as the chair. What will you have in store for 2024?
I'm not quite sure you can ever replace Kat Moss with Oliver, but I'm sure he'll do a great job. I've known Oliver for many years, probably in excess of 15 or 20 years. So we've got a good relationship as both customer and supplier. Lots of exciting things happening in LEEA that I'm proud to be part of. There's a fantastic new chatbot that will help with the technical advice that's coming online. So that'll help with the triage so that all of our members and non-members can ask questions on the safe use of lifting equipment, which is exciting. And also as a board, and we're working with Ross Maloney to look at the new members audit, which is extremely exciting, bringing that up into the 21st century.
When you speak about the members audit, what do you mean exactly?
All members, when they join LEEA, have to go through a process, and that process is audited every year or 2 years, depending on the company and how long they've been members. And it's a technical audit, and it's one where LEEA makes sure the members are still flying the gold standard. It's a way that customers and buyers can ensure that when they see the LEEA badge, that they know that it actually means something. It means that the members have been audited to a higher technical standard.
And how long will you be vice chair for?
I'll be vice chair for 2 years, starting in January 2024.
And so finally, you will become the chair. Are you nervous about that?
Well, it's never a foregone conclusion, but I'm excited if I do become chair. I hope to do so, obviously. I've passed my first LEEA exam in about 1989. And so LEEA has been part of my working life since I really started in the lifting gear industry. And so I'm very excited to be able to be part of the board and also to help run it for the members.
And you mentioned your working life. Tell us a little bit about what you do at Delphini.
So I'm the managing director of Delphini. I started Delphini in the year 2000. We started very humble beginnings, two or three people working for us in the port of Tilbury, specialising in port and shipping lifting equipment. We've now expanded over those 20 odd years. We've got some 34 people working for us now with a large manufacturing facility where we manufacture structural steels as well as lifting equipment and safety equipment, lifting beams and spreaders and so forth. So a massive change from our beginnings and one that we're looking to grow on.
Fantastic. 20 years. Well, more than 20 years.
Indeed. So if I do become chairman, the year that I become chairman will probably be our 25th year in business. So it'll be a fantastic double.
Fantastic silver anniversary.
Yes, indeed. Absolutely. It'll be something to look forward to.
And so what's next for you?
Obviously, lots of projects that we're doing in Delphini. We are pushing forward with trying to make all of our processes as digital as possible, which is a big challenge, but something that we're looking forward to. We manufacture to a higher standard. So we have EN 1090, which is a fabrication process certification. And by the middle of next year, we'll also have ISO 45001, which is the health and safety accreditation, which we find incredibly valuable to us, particularly as we've got lots of engineers going to sites. Those sites can be dangerous. So to make sure that we've got top tier health and safety is massively important to us.
Well, lots to look forward to, and congratulations on your new role.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Jenny.